Welcome back to week two, and in video four, we are going to move forward into the major volcanic hazards that are associated with volcanic activity. Now, a great website to visit is this volcanoesusgs.gov. It has a great interactive map to look at, which you can see here. Shows you all over the United States, different volcanoes, a little watch eye on Kilauea because it's currently active, has all sorts of awesome features. You can go to different observatories, Alaska, Hawaii, Washington, Oregon. Great website to explore. And they focus a lot mainly on the Cascades, the major eruptions that we've had in the past, and what's happening now, monitoring these volcanoes. But also the CVO, or Cascade Volcano Observatory, also has a program where they can monitor and help other countries that have active volcanoes present as well, which is pretty neat. So some of the hazards that are associated with volcanoes, especially with Cascade volcanoes, are earthquakes, landslides, pyroclastic flows, lahars, ash or tephra, and lava flows. Ash or tephra is what is shot up into the air here in this photograph, and it can travel for miles or around the globe if the winds are right. The gases present can produce acid rain. We can get what are called pyroclastic flows, which is basically a very hot, dense flow that hugs the surface of the earth and basically incinerates everything in its path and can move faster than a car. It can go hundreds of miles per hour. Just absolutely crazy. Lahars are produced when you have water or ice mixing with this hot material. Melts the ice, and then all this stuff flows as a big slurry downslope through any valleys that exist, and then lava flows, your typical lava flows that exist as well. So what we can do is, after the major Mount St. Helens eruption, what the USGS did was produce this hazard map. So most volcanoes have this for them. You can look at the USGS site and find one for Mount Hood. You're going to do that in lab. And basically it uses historical data and geologic data to basically figure out, okay, when this volcano erupted in the past, what was affected, where did this debris go, who needs to be warned if this volcano is going to go. So we have three different zones on this map. Zone one is basically the danger zone. This is like, if you're in this area, you better run or hide, because basically you're going to be vulnerable to some pretty hot pyroclastic flows, lava flows, and maybe some lahars. Zone two, a little further away in yellow, pyroclastic surges and flows. And then zone three, you can see follow some of these valleys, and those are the areas that will be inundated by lahar flows. And you can see that some of that debris can go as far as the Columbia River. When Mount St. Helens blew in 1980, the Columbia River had to be dredged because there was so much debris that made it down there. So what the USGS has done is built these sediment retention structures, which is basically a dam that will stop these flows, let the particles settle out, and then they drain the water off later to stop that material from clogging up the rivers below. And here you can see Mount St. Helens eruption. There's the tephra, the ash that went up in the air, and then the pyroclastic flow that hugged the surface. And this was produced by a landslide that basically collapsed one side of the mountain as it was erupting. Pretty intense stuff. We also can get lava flows. So these are more of a hazard in Hawaii, where we have these effusive eruptions that can be produced. They're pretty much unstoppable, but if they're small enough, you might be able to divert using rock walls or water if it's small enough. But usually you're not going to stop it. You can only divert it. An example is in Hawaii, when the Pu'o'o volcano erupted and basically buried an entire community. They couldn't stop it. It was too much lava, too fast, and the whole place was just gone, which is sad. There is one person actually who still lives there. He was protected. His house did not get lost, but he has to hike in and out because all the roads are destroyed. We also can get tsunamis, so when a volcano erupts, if enough material falls into the ocean, submarine volcano occurs, we can get tsunamis that are produced. And kind of the silver lining here is that these volcanoes have a pretty extensive monitoring system on them. So the Cascades Volcano Observatory is pretty awesome at monitoring all these volcanoes and being able to figure out, okay, what's happening? Is there going to be an eruption? Should we warn people? And here on Mount Rainier, we can see in the foreground here a monitoring site that has that monitors seismic activity, earthquakes, the tilt of the surface, and then GPS. So basically what they do at these sites is they measure some small earthquakes that can be produced as magma is moving underneath the surface. That could be a sign that the volcano is going to blow. Measuring the surface tilt can be another warning sign. If magma and pressure is building up inside the earth, the surface is going to be deformed. And then GPS units to see if things change at all. There's a great map that you can view of Mount Rainier, and it has all these different monitoring sites. You can click on each one and it tells you what it's monitoring, and you can look at, this is monitoring seismic, and if we look at the seismic data for the last 24 hours, we can see how many earthquakes have happened, which is pretty neat. I'll let you guys explore that on your own time. And those are the major hazards. So make sure you visit those websites. We're gonna look at them in lab as well. And make sure you're prepared, because we live in a hazardous zone. We're close to a volcano, and you need to know what to do if it goes. So check out those websites.